Hi everyone, welcome to another revision video. This one's going to be a chemistry topic. We're going to look at how to do reactant masses calculations. Now, if you're not 100% sure how to calculate the number of moles of a substance or calculate relative formula mass, I'd recommend you have a look at my videos on those topics before watching this video. You'll need to be really confident in those skills to be able to do these calculations. You can think of reactant masses calculations as a bit like the chemistry version of recipes for baking cupcakes. You might ask yourself, if I've got 6 eggs, how many cupcakes am I going to be able to make from those eggs? You've got a set number of ingredients to start with. You want to know what the maximum product you can make is. Or on the other hand, you might know that you definitely want to make 12 cupcakes and you want to know how many eggs am I going to need to buy to be able to make those 12 cupcakes. Reactive masses calculations are basically the chemistry version of this question. You might know you have a certain mass of reactant in your chemical reaction and you want to know how much product you can make. For example, if 72 grams of magnesium reacts with an excess of chlorine, how much magnesium chloride could be produced? Now, to do these questions, you're going to need the balanced symbol equation for the reaction, which is shown here. We know that we're starting with 72 grams of one of our reactants, magnesium. It says we have an excess of chlorine, which means we have as much as we need, and we're trying to work out how much magnesium chloride can be made. Now, to do that, we're going to need to work out the number of moles of magnesium that we have. We do this using the equation moles equals mass over relative formula mass, or moles equals mass over atomic mass if it's just an atom of an element. We want to work out the number of moles of magnesium that we have so we can work out how many moles of magnesium chloride we're going to make. We'll use the equation moles equals mass over atomic mass. Now, we know the mass is 72 grams, and to find the atomic mass, we need to look on the periodic table for the bigger number on magnesium symbol, so that's 24. Mass over atomic mass would be 72 divided by 24, and that would give us 3 moles of magnesium. We're starting off with 3 moles of magnesium, and that means we're going to make 3 moles of magnesium chloride. Once we know how many moles of magnesium chloride we're going to make, we can convert that back into a mass to figure out what the mass of 3 moles of magnesium chloride would be. To do that, we're going to use a rearranged version of the first equation. If you rearrange moles equals mass over MR, you get mass equals moles times MR. The number of moles is 3. To work out the MR, or the relative formula mass of magnesium chloride, we need to add together the atomic masses of magnesium and 2 chlorine atoms, which will be 24 plus 2 lots of 35.5, and that gives us a relative formula mass of 95. So we do 3 moles times a relative formula mass of 95. That will tell us that the mass of magnesium chloride in 3 moles would be 285 grams. That means that if we start with 72 grams of magnesium, the maximum mass of magnesium chloride we'd be able to make is 285 grams. For all of these questions, we take the same approach. We work out the number of moles, work out the number of moles of the other substance, and then convert that back into a mass. Here's a couple of practice questions for you to have a go at. If 24 grams of magnesium reacts with an excess of chlorine, what mass of magnesium chloride will be produced? So it's the same reaction. Here's the balanced symbol equation for that reaction. You're starting with 24 grams of magnesium this time, and we're trying to work out how many grams of magnesium chloride will we be able to make. And the second question is quite similar. Calculate the mass of magnesium needed to produce 100 grams of magnesium chloride. So it's the same symbol equation. This time we want to make 100 grams of magnesium chloride, and we want to work out how many grams of magnesium we'll need. Here are the symbols for magnesium and chlorine, so you can use their relative atomic masses. Pause the video and have a go at these questions. The first step is to work out the number of moles of magnesium that we have. We do that using the equation moles equals mass over atomic mass. The mass is 24 because we got 24 grams, and the atomic mass of magnesium is 24. That means we have 1 mole of magnesium to start with. If we start with 1 mole of magnesium, we're going to make 1 mole of magnesium chloride. So now we just need to work out the mass of 1 mole of magnesium chloride. We do that using that rearranged equation. We multiply the moles of magnesium chloride by the relative formula mass of magnesium chloride. That will be 1 mole times the relative formula mass of 95. And that means we're going to make 95 grams of magnesium chloride. So if we start with 24 grams of magnesium, we're going to be able to make up to 95 grams of magnesium chloride. Now for the next question, we take a similar approach, but this time we start with the moles of magnesium chloride because that's the one we know the mass for. We use the equation moles equals mass divided by relative formula mass. The mass is 100 grams and we've already worked out that the relative formula mass is 95. 100 over 95 is 1.05 moles. We know we need to make 1.05 moles of magnesium chloride, and that means we need to start with 1.05 moles of magnesium. Now we just have to work out the mass of 1.05 moles of magnesium by doing moles times atomic mass. The number of moles is 1.05, and we times that by the relative atomic mass of magnesium, which is 24. That gives us a mass of 25.2 grams. That means if we want to make 100 grams of magnesium chloride, we're going to need to use 25.2 grams of magnesium to start with. In some reactions, chemicals might not react in a one-to-one ratio. You might need twice as much of one chemical as you do of the other. For example, calculate the mass of sodium chloride formed from 142 grams of chlorine. So we're starting with 142 grams of chlorine, and we want to work out what mass of sodium chloride we will be able to make. Notice that there's a number 2 before the sodium, and there's no number before the chlorine. That means that for every 2 moles of sodium, only 1 mole of chlorine will react. That means we need twice as many moles of sodium as we do chlorine. Notice that there's also a number 2 in front of the sodium chloride. That means that for every mole of chlorine, we're going to make 2 moles of sodium chloride. Chlorine doesn't have a number in front of it, and that means that we only have 1 mole of chlorine. So 1 mole of chlorine will produce 2 moles of sodium chloride. Just as with the last questions, we'll use the equation moles equals mass over relative formula mass to work out the number of moles of chlorine. The mass is 142 grams. And the relative formula mass of chlorine is 2 lots of 35.5, which is 71. If we do 142 divided by 71, that tells us we're starting with 2 moles of chlorine. If we have 2 moles of chlorine to start with, and we know that for every mole of chlorine, we'll make 2 moles of sodium chloride, if we start with 2 moles of chlorine, that means we must make 4 moles of sodium chloride. Because we will always make twice as many moles of sodium chloride as we started with chlorine. Now we know the number of moles of sodium chloride that we are going to make, we can work out the mass of 4 moles of sodium chloride. 4 moles times a relative formula mass of 58.5 for sodium chloride tells us that we're going to make 234 grams of sodium chloride. That means if we start with 142 grams of chlorine, we can make up to 234 grams of sodium chloride. These two questions are practice questions that involve different molar ratios. If 71 grams of chlorine reacts with an excess of sodium, what mass of sodium chloride is produced? It's the same equation as before. The balance symbol equation is here. So we're starting with 71 grams of chlorine, and we want to know how much sodium chloride we can make from those 71 grams. The symbols for sodium and chlorine are here for you to work out the relative formula mass. The second question says calculate the mass of chlorine needed to produce 100 grams of sodium chloride. Same equation. We want to make 100 grams of sodium chloride and we want to know how many grams of chlorine we'll need to make those 100 grams. Pause the video and give these questions a try. So for the first question, we work out the number of moles of chlorine by doing moles equals mass over relative formula mass. The mass is 71. The relative formula mass is 71. That means we're starting with 1 mole of chlorine. Because we make twice as many moles of sodium chloride as the number of moles of chlorine that we started with, that means if we start with 1 mole of chlorine, we're going to make 2 moles of sodium chloride. Then we just need to work out the mass of 2 moles of sodium chloride. We're going to use the equation mass equals moles times relative formula mass. The number of moles is 2 and the relative formula mass of sodium chloride is 58.5. That means we'll make 117 grams of sodium chloride. So if we start with 71 grams of chlorine, we can make up to 117 grams of sodium chloride. The The next question is very similar, but we work out the number of moles of sodium chloride that we want to make. The mass is 100 grams. The relative formula mass is 58.5. That means we want to make 1.71 moles of sodium chloride. We need to start with half as many moles of chlorine as the number of moles of sodium chloride that we want to make because they're in that 1 to 2 ratio. So if we want to produce 1.71 moles of sodium chloride, we need half as many moles of chlorine, which would be 0.855 moles of chlorine. Now we know how many moles of chlorine we'll need, we work out the mass by doing 0.855 moles times the relative formula mass of chlorine, which is 71. And that gives us 60.7 grams. That tells us that if we want to make 100 grams of sodium chloride, we're going to need 60.7 grams of chlorine to be able to do that. Thanks so much for watching. I really hope this video has been useful for you, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye-bye.